Hello everyone, this is Reverend Dr. Rebecca Michael, and today I'm doing a mini Bible study for YouTube on the Nature of God series that I'm starting a new playlist over at my Phoenix 7 TV site over at YouTube. And Rebecca Michael 7, I have a few sites there. And so today I'm doing that God is an all-consuming fire. This is one of his attributes. And so this is going to be a theological set of studies to do with the attributes of God, the nature of God. And so I have tools and tips for you anytime that I do these Bible studies, these mini studies. And I suggest that you get a Strong's Concordance and cross-reference it with dictionaries and a Bible to do with fire, the topic of fire. Look up fire. If you go to the Strong's Concordance, there are under fire about 2 pages or more on fire, and quite a few scriptures that you could do an exhaustive study. I also suggest some online tool tips for you in the original languages. E-sword.net is a free program you can download, which will give you all these, for example, if you look up these Bible verses, it will give you the meanings of the word, say, fire, in the Hebrew and the Greek, in the Old or the New Testament. And another one you might try is www.biblegateway.com, and you can look up topical dictionaries and commentaries over there. And so today I'm opening the Concordance under fire, and I'm just going to give you a few scriptures, for example, that it has under fire. Here's Psalm 104. It references fire as spirits, his spirits being a ministering flaming fire. I'm going to get into this a little bit more in the second slide. Jeremiah 4:4 in the Concordance here, lest my fire come forth like flames. 5:14, make my words in thy fire mouth fire. 11:16 for Jeremiah, he hath kindled fire upon it. So we see that fire has symbolic meanings in the Bible. Also Hebrews 12:18, and he had burned with fire. And Hebrews 12:29, for our God is an all-consuming fire. Now that's very important, because fire is actually an inherent nature in God, as we'll see in the next slide. Isaiah, Moses, Ezekiel, and the Israelites all saw God in the form of fire, which we'll get to in the next slide. Jude 7, the vengeance of eternal fire. So we see that fire is used referencing judgment. And Revelations, there are several references to fire here. One is war, or many to do with wrath, the wrath of God, symbolically and or literally, literal judgment. And we see Revelations 15:2, and the prophet saw heaven as a sea of glass mingled with fire. And so those are the references from the Strong's that I would encourage you to start your Bible study. A good place just to get you started. This is just a mini series and some ideas, tools, and tips for you to get you started in the direction of studying the nature of God, which is, we'll never get to the end of studying, but these are some ideas of where you could start first, and you could learn a lot about this particular attribute of God, because it says in Hebrews, like I just said, that our God is an all-consuming fire, and we see fire throughout the Bible. There are literally pages and pages of fire in the Concordance here, so it's a really good thing to study. And so now that I got you started in the direction of some tools and tips for Bible study on this particular attribute of God, fire, I would like to just have a little discussion, note some things about fire that we do know about it from the sciences, etc., and from creation. For example, the stars in the cosmos, these are, of course, all balls of fire, varying degrees. Universe is literally ablaze, this physical universe. And they think there are probably several other dimensions that we are, for whatever reason, don't have access to. but in these four dimensions. You know, we're talking about this physical universe. You know that the stars are all balls of fire. We know that there could be no life, because there'd be no light and there would be no life, no warmth, no heat without fire. So we see that fire creates life, that the essence of God is, you know, creates life, fire. We see that it's in the Bible, it's a purifier and a cleanser. I suggest that you get also Bible commentaries and dictionaries that you can get over at www.biblegateway.com, freely available online resource for you. It is used in scriptures to do with judgment and wrath. If you take a look through the Strong's Concordance, you get a general overview. You see that it was used for judgment, for example, in Sodom and Gomorrah, hellfire, for example, at the end of time. The second coming of Jesus Christ says that he came, the first time he judged the world with a flood, the second time he's coming with fire, and the whole heavens and earth are going to burn up and be recreated, and there's just going to be in or out of Christ. And so Jesus has already won this on the cross, the King of the Kingdom of God. And so heaven is also described as a sea of glass mixed with fire before the throne of God. And so fire is everywhere to do with God. I had a vision of it that I also have on one of my playlists there, Prophetic Visions of God in Fire, in 1989. You might want to take a look at that. Prior to that, I just thought fire had to do with hell. This was totally outside of any knowledge I had. And that's when I started to study fire as an actual attribute of God. But I've got it in one of my playlists there. And the fourth way, the way that God can use this is through symbols, like I said. For example, in the Bible, it speaks of trials by fire, etc., that our trials are like by fire. When he judges, he has two judgments. He'll have the Bema seat of judgment, which all believers will stand before. People that are washed and belong to Jesus Christ, their works, their good works, will be tried with fire. For gold, silver, and precious stones will remain. Those are all symbolic of various aspects, like truth. One of the meanings of truth symbolically in the Bible is silver and gold, as referenced sometimes as faithfulness. And precious stones, well, these would be good works. So those will stand, those that are done and led by the Holy Spirit, by His Word. But wood, hay, and stubble are works, good works that we've done in the flesh, that were not led by God, but were us trying to help God, those will burn up. God doesn't need our help. And if you read the Bible, you see that many well-intended people could even die, Asa, I believe his name was, that tried to catch the altar of God, and he was forbidden to touch the altar of God. He instantly died, because you had to have exact prescriptions to touch the Ark of God when God was in the Ark. But he isn't in the Ark now, he's in his people. And so, you know, only works that are ordained of God, good works, will be saved at the Bema Seat of Christ. Now that's the believer's judgment. The unbeliever's judgment, of course, none of their works will be acceptable. That won't be the issue. The issue will be that they've rejected the Son of God. And so then we have the wrath of God coming down on them. The same wrath that came on the Son of God will now be coming down on them. And that's the hellfire, outer darkness. And there is a fire that's so hot, they know in physics, that it's transparent. So fire and darkness could go together. And so that's when God withdraws all his goodness and love. And so, yes, this fire is both holy and scary.